Do you literally use GPT-3?
We do. In fact, we just published a paper about it. We won the best paper award at one of the workshops at ACL. In that particular case, we were using GPT-3 for generating training data for language summarization. So that's an interesting approach. I think one that I know several people are following in different domains, but instead of using GPT-3 directly at inference time, to use it as a way to enhance and generate high volumes of training data with different priming mechanisms. It's a very interesting approach, and one that we showed in our publication that it's actually better than just having a lot of humans generating training data. So that's an interesting...
Wait, can you tell me more about how this works? So how do you exactly generate the data, and what's the summarization task?
It is a summarization task, and summarization of medical conversations is pretty hard because you need to generate the data, but also you need to generate data that is, sorry, you need to generate, you need to have the original data, but then generate summaries, and you need to generate summaries and examples of summaries which are mostly correct, but some that might be incorrect, to sort of like also make decisions on when you're training the model. It has to learn like what is a good medical summarization and what's a bad medical summarization. So in the case of this project, what we did is prime GPT-3 with a number of examples of both positive and negative summaries to conversations. Mm-hmm. And then have it generate thousands of different training examples that we use to train our own offline model. And interestingly, I mean, the availability of more data, but also more nuanced variabilities that GPT-3 was generating itself, was made that the final model that we were training was better than anything that we could have trained with our own data and our own human labelers.
If you're enjoying Gradient Dissent, I'd really love for you to check out Fully Connected, which is an inclusive machine learning community that we're building to let everyone know about all the stuff going on in ML and all the new research coming out. If you go to wmb.ai/FC, you can see all the different stuff that we do, including Gradient Dissent, but also salons where we talk about new research and folks share insights, AMAs where you can directly connect with members of our community, and a Slack channel where you can get answers to everything from very basic questions about ML to bug reports on weights and biases to how to hire an ML team. We're looking forward to meeting you.